What's up, guys? How's it going? It is Matt here, and I'm freezing my butt out here in a very snowy area. So I know there's some people that follow me down in Florida. They love the snow. So here's some pictures. Arsenal, there you go. You got some pictures out there for snow. But anyway, I'm gonna talk about a trend that I've been seeing in some of my comments in my prepping survival videos. And I want to address a couple things in that. So let's get into it. For some reason, there's some of my old videos I did, like year and a half old videos I did for like prepping, are really getting pushed by outside sources. I don't know why they're getting pushed for outside sources. One's the point where it's within a week, it got over 12,000 views, and actually it's just exploding. It's literally turning exploding. And one thing I noticed is whenever one of my videos gets out, that's when a lot of crazies come out. it is part of being on YouTube. If you're making a YouTube channel and you get a video that goes viral, well, not quite viral, but if you have a video that starts taking off, you're going to have some crazies that come out. But anyway, so I want to talk about a specific type of it that I just been deleting the comments and blocking the people that do it. It's like this is, okay, I'm a man of faith. All right. I'm a Christian. I believe in God. All right. I went to church growing up. I was acolyte. I've always been a man of faith. When I was overseas, I knew for a fact that something was out there protecting you, wrapping their arms in a loving hug, protecting you. When you see mortar fire coming in, there's no way you could have possibly survived, and you did. When you see rounds hitting the ground in front of you, hitting the armor in front of you on the back of AAV, and for some reason, doesn't any one of us around you, you know that someone is looking out for you. You know that someone is protecting you. All right, so faith for me is very real. It's very much a part of my life, and I don't talk too much about it on video because I just haven't really talked much about it on video. But I'm gonna get into it because one of the trends in the comments I've been seeing in the videos, in my prepping videos, is people can't separate God from guns. They can't separate God from guns, and they have kind of a twisted version of what God is when it comes to guns. And I have noticed it. And basically, what I mean by that is, they can't talk about guns in one sentence without talking about God. They can't talk about guns in one sentence without talking about God. They can't talk about weapons in one sentence designed to kill people without talking about God in the same sentence. They just can't. They can't bring themselves not to compare the two of them. And I understand I'm conservative, but the problem is with far right, whatever you want to call it, they're so far on either sides that they're not even on the same page as everyone else. They're basically so far that they're basically the same place. It's like a circle. All right, there's everyone in between. There's a left, there's a right, there's everyone in between. And then you're so far right and you're so far left that you're back to back together, and you're basically the same thing. You don't agree with each other, and you are set in. You have a list of things that you have to support regardless of what it is that you just sign up for, type of deal. You support them without a second of thought. And in that page, it's guns, gods, Second Amendment, all this other stuff. And you can't talk about one without talking about the other. Now, I'm getting into this because I've been seeing this twisted version of faith that really bothers me. As a Christian, it bothers me. There's this very twisted version of faith that people come through in the comments. So they'll respond in these long essay sentences, and they'll be quoting scripture and stuff like on that. But in that same exact essay question, when they're quoting scripture and talking about the importance of being a man of faith and being a woman of faith or whatever it is, at the same sentence, they also say you need to kill a motherfucker or kill commies or kill this or kill that or kill Israel or kill that. How can you put those two in the same paragraph? I mean, how can you? If you're honestly a person of faith, a Christian, which I assume you guys are, if you're a man of faith, a woman of faith, a Christian, and you're talking about this stuff, how can you judge everyone else that doesn't go in the same way as you and tell them that they need to die? It does not sit on the same page. That is not faith, all right? That is not Christianity, your version of it. That is not Christianity. Just because you quote scripture doesn't mean that you can, at the same sentence, also tell them to shoot someone in the face. You can't do the same thing. You can, but that's not faith. And you can't say, because of this faith, you're allowed to shoot this person in the face, all right? That's not what it is. Faith is faith. Faith is about being the best person you possibly can. Except, I'm not going to get into Christianity, but basically faith is that Jesus came down, all right? Jesus came down, the Son of God came down and took away our sins. He was a perfect person, an honest person. He helped people every step of the way. Everything he did was teaching and helping every step of the way. You can't quote him when he was not a violent man and saying that in order to be a man of faith, you have to shoot this person in the face, or in order to be a man of faith, that you have to kill all this types of purple, like you have to commit genocide on this group. You can't do the same, All right. The last people that did something like that were called Nazis. All right. They were Germans back in World War II, not the modern day version of what people say Nazis are. Germans back in World War II that believed all other species other than them should die in the name of faith. All right. And trying to use, and we're looking for spiritual items to create that genocide. You cannot do that. All right. That is not faith. That is a twisted version of faith. If you're honestly a person of faith, Christianity, that is you being tempted so much that you were going the way of Satan. Is basically you're going the way of Satan wanting to commit genocide in the name of a God, all right, and a God. And that ain't my God. That ain't Jesus. That ain't God, all right? It's not about killing other people in the name of faith, all right? So if you're going to be commenting on my video saying that I'm a person that doesn't have good spiritual health, when you're sitting there telling that other people should die, you need to rethink about what you're, you know, you need to rethink a few things. You really do. You know, maybe when you're reading those scriptures, when you're going through scriptures, you actually read them and actually pay attention to them instead of taking them and only taking the parts that you like and applying it to your political versions, all right? Faith is not about politics. Faith is about faith, okay? Faith is not about guns. Guns are firearms. They're weapons in defense that defend you, defend the other people. They're in defense of danger and tyranny. That's what firearms are for. It's not like a blessed thing that's designed to, you know, conquer the world. All right, that's what these guys sound like. It sounds like to them, guns mean they need to conquer the world in the name of their faith and commit genocide in order to do that. I consider that hate speech, guys. I consider that hate speech in my comments, and I report and I block them, especially the people that tell me that they all Israelis need to die. I don't know where you guys are getting that information from. I don't know where you how you guys got so twisted along the way. That is just wrong, all right? That is wrong. Genocide is not faith. All right. If you are in a faith that is, if you're in a faith that promotes genocide, you are not in a good faith. You are in a dark faith. So if it promotes genocide, that is not that's not faith. That's not the spiritual end of it. The light end of it. That's Satan. That's the dark. That's the devil. That's the bad stuff. That's what that is. That's not the Christianity I know. And that's not the Christianity other people know. So I don't talk too much about my faith and stuff like that, my Christianity. I don't talk about that because I try to keep that stuff separate from the guns. But for some people just can't separate the two of them. But the problem is that they combine them together, and then they have this twisted version of what way they consider faith. But all they're really doing is they're taking scripture and they're quoting it only when it's important for their politics, and they use their anger and their hate or in their rage against other people and their stuff, and they try to use faith in order to back that. And that is just dead wrong. All right, that is just dead wrong. So if you're one of those people commenting on the video something about that, I will block you. I will also report you as hate speech. Okay, I will. All right, because there's a difference between actually being faith, having good morals, doing the best, live the best life you can, protect people that you love, protect everyone, try to be the best person you possibly can to the rest of the world, and what you guys are talking about. There's a big, big difference. Anyway, guys, if you like this video, like, share, subscribe, tell your friends about me, and remember, it's our responsibility to take care of each other and protect each other. Peace.